command your morning. My name is Bishop John Kamande Joroge of Glory Celebration Church. I welcome you to our word this morning. Our title is about Steps to Your Miracles. Steps to Your Miracles. We shall get from the text of Mark chapter 5, verse 35 to 43. This was a miracle that was done by Christ to one of the synagogue rulers. One of the synagogue ruler who had a daughter that was sick. And the ruler had known the power, the authority that was in Christ. And therefore, he came to Christ to seek for his help. And when he was there waiting to talk to Jesus Christ, some people or some men came from the house of Jairus, from his house. And they told him, "Your daughter is dead. Why bother the teacher anymore?" But I thank God because Jesus Christ himself assured Jairus. He ignored the voices that were coming from those men. He ignored them. And he said to Jairus, "Don't be afraid, just believe." And therefore, once you are in Christ Jesus, you should expect miracles to happen just like a way of life. When things happen, when things are needed, when disease comes our way, we should expect the miracle of healing. When we are in scarcity, we should expect a miracle of provision. When we are facing any difficulties in life, we should expect God to come through and perform a miracle in our midst, because he lives in us and he walks in us. Therefore, when Jesus Christ was being given this message, and then a negative message came, he told Jairus, "Do not be afraid," because of the negative message that you are getting from these people, because they do not believe in the supernatural. We need to ignore the critics. Those guys that brought this message and told him, "Don't bother, don't ask the master, don't tell him to come. Your child is already dead." They were speaking from the natural mind. They had seen it. They had seen their daughter who was already dead. But Jesus Christ ignored all that because he is a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. I want to urge you to be a miracle believing saint. I want you to be a miracle believing saint of God, because signs and wonders will follow us as we follow Christ. I want you to have faith. You may have something that you are believing God for, like these Jairus, like these synagogue ruler, who had come to Jesus Christ because he had reached the end. When we reach the end, that's when Christ himself starts. Therefore, if you have an issue, you need to come to him believing. Be a believer. Believe in the word of God. Miracles do happen even in our days. And therefore, Jesus Christ is waiting for us. We need just to believe, and then a miracle will happen in your life. Therefore, even if you meet people who will tell you it can't work, it used to work during the days of the apostles, tell them, "I am a believer of today, and that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And he will not change." Therefore, believe in him. He is able to perform a miracle for you, child of God. You need to chase fear out of your life. You need to have that your eyes focused on him. He who started a good work in you, he is able to accomplish it. He is able to back the words that you speak with miracles and wonders. Therefore, it is important for us to believe that he works, and it will work for you. The next step that you need to have, once you ignore the critics, the naysayers, that it says it cannot work, it used to work in a certain age and generation, and once you put your faith in Jesus Christ, You need now to surround yourself with the believers, not doubters. There are many doubters in this life. There are people who do not even believe in themselves. Everything, they doubt everything. They doubt our faith. They doubt themselves. Whatever they do it in doubt. In verses 37, it says, he did not let anyone follow him except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. Why? There were so many people outside there. Those who had come to bring the message, all of them were waiting. And there were so many other mourners who had come to comfort the family. But Jesus Christ, when he came into the family, because he had assured the Father, he should not fear, but believe. He himself chose only the Father, the Mother, and then his three disciples, and he went with them. He did not want to encourage doubt in his prayer. He did not want to encourage doubt where he was praying for a miracle to happen. And therefore, he was focused on that miracle. He was looking at the word of God. You need to believe what God says is true. We need to say what God says is, that is the real thing. That is the real deal. Whether people whether people critique it or whether they do not like it, we need to realize that we have the real deal in the word of God. Therefore, if you have an issue and you are going to God in your closet to pray, remove the doubters. I have a lady in our church who is a believer in the word of God. At one time, I came from outside the country, and she came to my house, and she told me, Pastor, I want to live in your house. I want to take care of your child. Why? It is because I want to get the anointing of going outside. I want now my doors to be opened of going outside this country. And she's an old lady, but she believed God for, you could doubt whether she would be able to make a trip like that in life. But she stayed there. She said, I want to help here. I want to help your girl. I want to help this child to take everything, to be doing everything in this house, because I want to get an anointing of going outside. To speak the truth, I didn't even know whether it would work that way. But I tell you, she believed. She did not want anybody to mess up with her faith. After leaving my place, just 1 month, I heard she was going to Tunisia, to the ambassador's house, to become a worker in his house. And then I called her and I said, Mama so-and-so, you are a great woman of faith. She persisted in her faith. And not only that, that lady told me, Pastor, and when we have lived with her, she was not married. She had one child who passed away. And then she told me, you know, Pastor, I never got married. I got this child outside marriage, and she has passed away. But I believe God for a wedding. Believe you me, now in September, we are having her wedding. She is wedding, and she's about 8 years of old. And she is wedding a wonderful, glorious marriage. I want to tell you, faith, when you are praying about an issue, remove doubters out of your life. Surround yourself with believers. And the other step towards your miracle is that don't give undue attention to distractors. People will always distract you. People will always look you down. People will always adulate you. Do not listen to them. Verses 9 says, he went in and he said to them, why all this commotion and wailing? The child is not dead, but asleep. But they laughed at him. Some people will laugh at the vision that you have. Don't listen too much to people who talk behind your back, to people who talk as you pass, to people who say things that, say things that always distract you from your focus. Always do not give a lot of attention to them. Just tell them, pass, I have a message, I have a mission. That is what David did. Even when he was derided by his own brothers, own blood brothers, and he was asking, what shall be done to the man who shall kill this Goliath and remove shame to Israel? And his brothers were telling him, go and look at those sheep of, you know, at those sheep. You know, they compared him just to a shepherd. But there was something that was working within him. I believe, child of God, God is working something in your life. Faith is being built. That vision that you had is being built by God. But it has enemies, the distractors, the naysayers. All of them want to put it down. And they are causing commotion. There is a lot of commotion happening. Do not be distracted by the people that are laughing at you. God wants to take you places. Just believe in him. He believes in you also. Praise the name of the Lord. The other thing that we also need to know is that we need to allow only those who have stake for the miracle. Don't take everybody concerning the miracle that you have with you. Do not take everybody. Just take the stake. He took the parents. He did not take aunties. He did not take uncles. He did not take the neighbors. He just took the father and the mother who had the, you know, the pain of the child. And therefore, he took them in because they had a stake in the child's life. And therefore, he took them because they would also pray together with him. Once you have something in you, you have a child that is growing in you, you have a pregnant of a faith in God concerning an issue that God wants, you'd want God to accomplish in your life, trust God. Praise the name of the Lord. Trust God, because the Lord will be able to carry that vision through. He understands you. He knows your weaknesses. Carry people who will pray together with you. Carry people who have your pain in your heart. Let them be your prayer partners. Let them be your burden carriers. Don't allocate things to people who do not care. You tell them to pray, they will never pray. You tell them to be with you, they will never be with you. They will never sacrifice anything to you. Take those people who have a stake in what you are doing, the real friends. That's when we realize and learn who our friends are. Amen. The other thing that you need to know or to have for you to have your miracle is that you need to command the situation to turn around. You need to learn to speak the word. You need to learn to say the word with power. You need to learn to say the word the way God wants you to. Because God has faith in you. Once you are here, God knows he has a representative in this world. He calls you, you are his ambassador. So your voice matters in this world. What you say counts in heaven. Angels of heaven know that you have been given authority on earth. The devil knows that God himself trusts you. God himself, he respects the words that you speak. And therefore, it is important for us to realize as children of God that we have a mandate from heaven. Heaven is behind us. Heaven is backing us. Heaven is with us. And therefore, we should speak like people with authority from heaven. We should speak like the children of God that we are. Therefore, command the situation. This is what Jesus did. In verse 41, he says, he took her by the hand and he said to her, Tarida kum, which means little girl, I said to you, get up, command your issues in the life that are dead. Child of God, signs and wonders shall follow those who believe. That is what the word of God says. We are in this world just like those apostles were. We have been commissioned of God. And therefore, we have the mantle from above. It is in us. And therefore, we need to speak to areas of our life that are not working. We need to speak to our country, to in areas that is not working. We need to speak to our economy. We need to speak to our leadership and say, God is able to change our situation. We shouldn't have that negative mentality that is with everybody. When the naysayers, when the distractors are talking, we need to speak words of faith. We want to plant seeds of faith in the minds of our children, in the minds of our families, in the minds of our relatives, in the minds of our communities. We need to say things that are dead can rise again. We need to say talitha kum to that situation in life, and it will be able to resurrect again. Believe you me, the word works. Believe you me, the word of God is able to heal. The word of God is able to heal. The other thing that you need to realize, as you believe in miracles, feed the resurrected. He said and told them to give her something to eat. Jesus, that is in verse 43. Once God has healed your state, your area of life that you are believing God for, you need to keep believing and feeding it with the word of God. You need to change your attitude toward the state that you are living in. And now live as a new being. Behold, the old is gone. The new has come. You need to feed. Anything that is fed lives. Anything that you do not feed cannot live. Speak life to your marriage. Speak life to your job. Speak life to your business. There are some businesses that are having a hard time now. We need to speak life into those businesses now. We need to feed them with the word of God. As you go into a business every morning, speak to it. It has ears. It can hear. Speak life to it. Speak health into your bodies. Speak life, you know, speak life to your health. And then you shall have health in your life. Speak life into every area of your life. Speak hope to your children. Speak hope to your family. Speak hope to our country. And then everything will go on well. I want us to pray. I want us to pray. Our Father, we want to thank you. We bless your name. There is none like unto you. We believe what you say is true, and it will work in our life. We want a turnaround. We want to command our situations in life that are dead, that there is life in Jesus Christ, our Lord, whom we believe in. Oh God, cause those areas to live again. Bless our country. Bless our families. Bless our communities. We thank you, Holy Father. Remember those people who are going through difficult times in life, and cause belief and faith to happen into their life. Thank you for everything, for you believe. In Jesus' holy name, we pray. Amen. And my name's, once again, I want to remind you, is Bishop John Kamande Joroge of Glory Celebration Church. We are based in Saika. We invite you to our services. God bless you. God bless you.